Welcome to the Beach House. Thanks for joining me today. This is Angie Gallion, and I'm coming to you with a new book review. Today's book review is Last Exit to Montauk by Philip Vega, and it's published by a small press out of Canton, Georgia called thewordverb.com. Thewordverb.com is a newly revisioned publishing house. It used to be a sort of a hybrid, and now it is strictly traditional publishing. So that means that they're taking on all the responsibility for marketing this book. And they're doing a great job. I have had this book sitting on my desk now for probably a month, and I keep walking past it because everywhere I look, I'm seeing Philip Vega, I'm seeing Last Exit to Montauk, I'm seeing author interviews, I'm seeing author takeovers of blogs, I'm seeing Philip Vega everywhere I look. So I kind of held off because I feel like my mission with this blog is to bring attention to self-published and small press works that nobody else is championing, things that I think have merit, that I think other people will enjoy, that don't really have any marketing behind them. So that's what I feel like my goal is. Well, I had just finished a book that I didn't feel I could do a review on because, as you all know, I will not bring somebody negative attention. So I had sent the author a nice long email explaining to them why I was declining to review their book and making some suggestions on how I thought they could make it better, and letting them know that in the future I would certainly be happy to look at it again if they got a second look at an editor. So I was a little depressed because I hate telling an author that because I feel like there's a lot of work that goes into making a book, but this particular book just was not print ready, and I couldn't honestly review it. So I wanted something that I would enjoy, and I knew I would enjoy this book because it sounded right up my alley. I'm not a huge fan of romance, and this isn't romance, but it is very much a love story. This book did absolutely everything that I want a book to do. This book let me walk inside the head of the main character. I became a 17-year-old boy falling in love with a girl that we know only as B throughout the novel. And I absolutely did fall in love with her. I fell in love with her laugh. I fell in love with the way that she moved. I fell in love with her speech patterns. I fell in love with the fact that she could eat more ice cream than any boy I've ever met in my life. And I loved her sense of humor. So this author does a beautiful job of taking you into the scene, into the moment, and making you feel, or letting you feel, everything that his character is feeling. And I think that takes true skill. So I enjoyed this book so much that at the end, I spent half an hour or so looking on the internet to see if it was a true story. I researched every name I could find, looking for information to find out whether this was a true story. I don't want to give it away, so I'm not going to tell you why I felt that way, but that's pretty powerful to make somebody spend time after reading the book looking for more information. Well, I definitely want more from this author, and I definitely think we'll see more from this author. I fully expect to see him on a bestseller list somewhere down the road, so you should keep an eye on him. And I think you should probably keep an eye on his publisher because they're doing it the right way, thewordverb.com. They are giving personal attention to their authors. I think they're going to be very selective about who they include, and I think they're going to give them the utmost care. So check out Philip Vega's new book, The Last Exit to Montauk. It will make you feel things you may not have known you could feel. Thanks for joining me. Check out the full review at www.angiegallion.com, and hope to see you next week. Thanks for joining me.